have been working around the clock during those days, and I am proud to see that the European Union has been able to show its capacity to deliver, to help its neighbors with the idea of urgency. This is good, to be able to deliver with the idea of urgency when one of our neighbors and partners is being invaded by Russia. The Council has been given his assessment, his support, his political agreement for a package of support of the Ukrainian armed forces, for new sanctions, for diplomatic engagements in order to isolate Russia, for measures to support Ukraine and the region, and measures to counter disinformation. We have decided to use our capacities to provide arms, lethal assistance to the Ukrainian army by a value of 450 million of support package and 50 more millions for the non-lethal supplies, fuel, protective equipment. I want also to thank Poland, who has offered to serve as a logistic hub for the transfer of this assistance, this material assistance, to Ukraine. And we will also work to enhance the cyber defense of Ukraine. On sanctions, we have agreed to increase the peoples and entities that are going to be subject to restrictive measures. The full list will be finished by the repair and published tomorrow. This includes Russian oligarchs and businessmen whose listing carries huge economic impact, and political figures who hold key role of the Putin system in Russia, both the ones who disseminate propaganda, propagandists, and military. In addition, we have decided to close the European Union airspace to the Russian aircraft. We are taking a package of measures who are really effectively cripple the Russian financial market. We are excluding a certain number of Russian banks from SWIFT, impose restrictive measures that will paralyze the assets of the Russian central bank, with a clear message that Russians who enable the invasion of Ukraine will have to pay a very high price for this action. We are going after the wealth of Putin's elite, people who support him and benefit from this regime. And in addition to this new package of sanctions, we are advancing work on sanctions regimes targeting corruption specifically, as well as foreign information manipulation and interference. Third line of work of the ministers today, engage on diplomatic efforts and work in order to make the widest possible international condemnation and isolation of Russia. Russia will be isolated by the international community. We are carrying an intensive effort, an intensive diplomatic effort to isolate Russia as much as possible in the international and regional organizations. The fourth is to support the people affected by the conflict, who will be in need of humanitarian assistance. We need to tackle disinformation. We need to counter the Russian state-controlled narrative. We need to be vigilant about an obvious manipulation. We have to fight against it. And for that, we are going to ban Russia Today and Sputnik from broadcasting in the Union. And last but not least, we are worried for what may happen in the whole region. The Russian influence can start working in the neighbor countries, Moldova and Georgia, and also will have an impact on the Western Balkans. This is a defining moment for Europe. This is the occasion to demonstrate strategic and global leadership in a united manner, to act united and quickly. European Union is a peace project, And we want to continue fighting for peace for us and for the humankind.